Hi, welcome back to Fishbowl of Fury. On to, I believe, the last sequence, or the last memory in sequence 8 before the final sequence, sequence 9. Really excited to see what happens, but this especially is going to be interesting because, yeah, this guy doesn't like Jacob anymore. And the memory being called Final Act is, yeah, it's quite interesting. So let's get started. Yeah, so, I should take my headset off and put that on. I don't need that. I'm actually a little bit nervous, to know what happens because I don't want Jacob to die. I can handle Evie dying, but not Jacob. Okay, Jacob must locate Maxwell Roth in the Alhambra Music Hall and assassinate him. Alright, I'll play his game. Ooh, that's a big hall. Wow.
Oscar Maria!
He went that way!
This way to the Alhambra!
Roth.
Assassinate Maxwell Roth. Usher is a stealth opportunity. Waitress is assistance. Machinist is a unique kill. Okay.
What's happening over there?
Has certainly come into its own this season.
Excuse me.
It has indeed, sir.
Eliza, is that really you?
Aren't these masks marvelous? Oh, it's a Christmas Santa. Ring his bell. Come on, come all. Give me money.
Mask guests this way.
Usher. Her? Loot a mask from Roth's guard near the music hall. Easy entry into the theater, find a mask and join the group.
May no. Ask the mask guests to line up.
Wait, her. She's the usher.
Mask guests this way.
Is that normal?
No, it ain't.
I will escort the next group into the theater shortly.
Please join the usher's group and be escorted into the theater.
The doors will open shortly.
If you want a
please
mask,
don your mask.
Talk to the man over there.
Something tells me this is going to be,
why can't you go inside?
See that
way.
Man? He only lets people who have masks enter.
Please put on your mask and join this group.
When will the doors open?
Please join the usher's group to be escorted into the theater.
Masks only. I repeat, ladies and gentlemen, this entrance is for masks only.
Masks only, and I'm not your pal.
May I ask the mask guests to line up over here, please?
I'm thinking maybe. I wonder.
Please join the ushers group to be escorted into the theater.
You better hope I don't get my hands on ya.
Did you hear that?
When will the doors open?
Please join the ushers group to be escorted
into
the theater.
Please put on your mask and join this group.
He's disappeared.
Wasting your time on you. Keep moving.
Why can't we go in, sir?
Push him straight on his back!
Oh, I guess this won't, you know, not allow me to get 100%. And I have less people to worry about later. Alright, loot you.
Masks only. I repeat, ladies and gentlemen.
Mind you, I heard they're paying good money at the College of
Brown Rat. Just minding
my own business.
Charge!
Ah, cool. So that was worth killing five guards for.
Just seen someone get killed. Titillating, to say the least.
Mask guest, this way. Let us enter the theater for tonight's performance.
I had a person come and tell him that there were.
Everyone ready? Then let's proceed.
Of course, half a mask is enough to make him unknown, despite the scar on his cheek going through his stubble.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Alhambra Music Hall. Tonight, we have, for one night only, a very special performance of Corvus the Trickster. While some of the effects may be visceral and highly disturbing, do not be alarmed, my good people. Fear not. This is a purest form of entertainment. Tonight's performance immortalizes and is for the benefit of a young fellow very near and dear to my heart. Any concerns or complaints may be addressed to him. Jacob, dear boy, tonight is
he
for
knows
you.
He's here. He knows.
Your wife is a rare gem, that one. I do admire her bravery.
This sort of evening is quite to her taste, sir.
Who are they? Just two guys chilling, I guess.
I'll be serving you this evening, gentlemen.
You're still here, love. Last time, I swear, you nearly poisoned us.
Scene two, stand by.
Need to lower the grid for the show!
Need to do what for the show? Okay. That's a kill.
Two
that
quarters and a ginger ale. If you please.
Right, you are, Mary.
I hate this godforsaken job. I should be up there performing the
line. We have a volunteer! A big round of applause for this brave, brave man! Our volunteer is about to die for you, Jacob.
Uh-oh. Oh, I bet it's Evie's boyfriend, maybe.
You lucky people are about to witness this gentleman being fired upon at point-blank range. Our performer will hit several targets placed around his head. Exciting, is it not?
Okay. Poisoning opportunity. Get close to her pitcher. Speak to the waitress to poison her pitcher. Words are poison.
Pain.
Not in your life.
Where's our honored guest go
good,
on, huh?
You best be paying, chap.
We British are a hardy bunch. Let's put that hardiness to the test. Uh-huh.
Excuse me, love. Just looking for the lavatory.
It's over there.
Thanks.
We got a visitor!
This one, I felt it up here! Keep it up!
Okay.
What are you up to?
Not her. I saw someone in yellow over there. That's who I was trying to.
What a thrill! Do not fret, my friends. It's all part of the show. Please stay with us as we prepare
that
for the next
can go hang
turn.
Himself. Mary, don't say that. You know he's no good, Jim.
Are
don't
your
treat
principles
any of us wrong,
drifting, dear?
Oh, those are decoys that I have to kill. Okay. Oh, I wonder if she'll kill them for me. That would make me so happy. Oh, I think she's gonna kill them for me. Oh, they're drinking. Are they dying? They're dying.
Yay.
One down. Three to go. Of course, she, I think, can only. She only has access to two. There's one's back there. One's okay. And one's down there. So.
Maybe another glass of the pale ale.
Just a minute, love.
Mr. Roth says he'll have me up there on the stage before you know it.
The search consumes you. Creed forgotten. Prey visualized. Mouth watering. We found a suitably flat-headed gentleman for this one. You laugh, ladies and gentlemen, but I assure you that is the case. I have no doubt that you could hazard a guess as to what this one concerns, my friends. Our courageous participant hasn't even flinched.
He's not flinching because he's already dead.
Standing a few feet away, our performer expertly throws his knives at the apple, slicing it in two. Will he or won't he?
I'll make this interesting.
The tide's turning.
Fight harder!
Watch yourself.
Okay, so that's three.
Go on, that's it.
Oh, I can't use ranged weapons. I just now noticed that. That's not fair. Why didn't that come up earlier? Oh, well.
The flavor intensifies the second time.
Maybe ranged weapons.
The hunt. Now a search for want rather than
if he's not Roth.
Oh well.
Leaves a strange taste in your mouth, doesn't it? Like eating pork when expecting venison. Well, we weren't quite expecting that. How thrilling it is when life surprises us. I am not finished just yet. Stay right where you are, and the show will continue shortly. You prefer tragedy to comedy. I knew you had exquisite taste.
That's really, that, I'm disappointed.
You know what?
I would go back
don't say
and
that. You know he's no good, Jim. Don't treat any of us right, you don't.
I would go back and restart, but I'm tired of restarting missions when I screw up. I'll just 100% this again later. This one's a fun one anyways, considering all of the posters, the Ezio and the Buccaneers poster. Okay, so I have to go on that side. Wrong side. Oh, what the? Okay. That cop has one of those hotel wine chiller buckets on his head. Someone's gonna need to be a little bit too much into the, fine hard alcohols. So I have to kill this guy. Oh, that's one. Oh, wait. I want to. Where? How do I? Do I have to go in from above?
Help! Help me! They locked me in
here! So why do I want to kill a guy who's?
For this trick, ladies and gentlemen, like we have found a most courageous volunteer. With our courageous volunteer in the box, the celebrated illusionist will proceed to saw him in half. Watch as our esteemed guest emerges unharmed. Our skilled illusionist, Sabretooth Jane, is performing this famous trick. She is said to have studied at the feet of the mysterious Torini himself. The saw Miss Jane is using this evening is imported from the ancient city of Gondola, celebrated for manufacturing the finest steel in the world. Behold the grace,
Miss
Jane.
Show
yourself.
What? Confused.
I hope you have enjoyed your evening so far, ladies and gentlemen. I know I have. Now, before our final act, I would like to toast all you brave people who joined us tonight to celebrate life and death. Go on! Toast them! Your move, Jacob, my dear! Burn!
Oh.
Burn!
Everyone?
Burn!
Oh, now I can get this guy.
Grab him! Drag them!
You know, he's not really important now, but...
Jacob, my dear, where are you? Don't hide from me, darling. Join me for the finale.
Oh.
That's a daisy. Tom Watchley.
Oh, that one. Okay. Cut the rope to assassinate the law. What rope? Oh. How is that gonna assassinate him? His foot, not his neck. See what the smoking man has to say.
Darling,
tonight. The stuff of legends.
Why did you do it? All of it.
What? Snap a baby crow's neck between my thumb and forefinger. Slice to bits the ones you deem innocent. Keep the world in its divine, manic state. For the same reason I do anything.
The smoking man is gay. That look on his face. It's like, did I like that or did I, am I repulsed by that? Now I have to escape death.
I'll never make it out alive. Damn this place from hell to Hackney.
Hell to Hackney. Ouch. Oh. So he didn't die. Yet. Maximum Dracula schematic. I am quite curious on what that is. Okay, let's see what happens. The joys of freedom.
Order has bred disorder. The sea rises to flood the pubs and extinguish the street lamps. Our city will die. Tupine has failed. Lucy has failed. Brudenell, Elliotson. Pearl. All have gone into the night. It is up to me now. The assassins have brought nature's fury into our homes. Men have become monsters, barreling toward us, teeth out. Our civilization must survive this onslaught. To prevent a return of the Dark Ages.
Oh no.
I will start anew. London must be reborn.
The Peace of Eden is under Buckingham Palace. All we need. Let's start planning our infiltration.
Hold on. Better to get visual verification. If we're going to move, we need to be 100% sure. We'll only get one shot before Otso Berg crashes down on us.
Gotta agree with Sean.
We'll position ourselves near the palace. But we'll wait for you to sync the genetic data before we move.
It's all up to you, Initiate.
Of course it is.
Starrick is making his move. The Peace of Eden is somewhere inside Buckingham Palace.
Let him have it.
I've seen your handiwork across the city. Perhaps you should trust my judgment.
I've been killing Starrick's henchmen. What have you been doing? Let's ask Henry, shall we?
I have been repairing your mistakes. Too much haste is too little speed.
Don't you quote father at me.
That's Plato. And I am sorry, this doesn't involve anything you can destroy. Father was right, he never approved of your methods.
Father is dead!
Enough!
I have just received word from my spies. At the palace ball tonight, Starek plans to steal the Peace of Eden, and then eliminate all the heads of church and state.
Once more for old time's sake?
And then we're finished.
Agreed. So what's the plan?
Such an honor, delight to visit you both. What is the news on the street?
She likes Jacob more.
Mrs. Disraeli, we have discovered that there is something inside Buckingham Palace that could threaten the...
What my sister's failing to say is that we require entrance into the ball tonight.
Impossible! Even if there were any invitation cards remaining, which there are not, someone of your lowly station...
If that damn fool Gladstone is attending this evening, they can have my card. Perfect. Then I'll go alone.
Mrs. Disraeli, if you would be kind enough to inform my darling brother of the location of the Gladstone's residence, perhaps he could use his considerable skills to commandeer their cards.
What fun! Did you hear that, Dizzy? We're going to pinch the Gladstone's invitations.
Thank you for volunteering me, sweet sister.
Oh, a pleasure, brother, dearest. Now, Mrs. Disraeli, if you would excuse me, I must visit with the Maharaja. It occurs to me that he may have a second set of plans to a certain vault.
So that was...
The nerve of Evie. Treating me like a child.
Getting less and less fond of Evie. So that was very weird. His I mean, obviously, you know, their dad dying, that's going to affect them. But he just didn't care, man. All right, so that was a pretty intense reaction on Jacob's part. Of course, Evie was also quite obnoxious. I knew something was going to happen, but I was hoping it was going to be something bigger than a pair of twins, you know, hating each other. Because, yeah, siblings always end up hating each other at one point or another. So yeah, I don't know, this sequence 9 is going to be interesting. I was going to say it's going to be good, but I'm going to hesitate to say that it's going to be good at this point, because unless someone dies, someone big dies, or, you know, I don't know, they got to put something in here to make this ending good. But anyway, thank you all for watching. Do comment, rate, subscribe, and I will see you all in the next video.